What's up, guys? I'm trying to learn how to make a proper breakfast. I already know how to make scrambled eggs, but I figure, who better to go to than the master himself, Gordon motherfucking Ramsay. Yes, that's his legal middle name as much as he uses the word. So, we are gonna check this video out here. It's... screensaver. We're gonna check the Gordon Ramsay scrambled eggs video out. So, let's get started. Alright, so let's start this off properly. Let's get this in HD and... Alright, that's fine. I don't judge. Real Legends upload in 360. That's why PewDiePie is doing so well. That's why. So, alright, let's get started on this then.
Breakfast. Never get a chance to eat it Monday to Friday, but Saturday, Sunday, however, is the time when everyone should have a proper breakfast. My perfect breakfast, scrambled egg, sautéed mushrooms and tomatoes. The most important thing about any scrambled egg is stopping it from overcooking. To serve us.
Alright, hang on, pause real quick. Hang on, did I make the speed? Why is he talking so No, that's normal speed. Okay. Maybe my man Gordon's just, you know, he's excited. Alright, that's fine. I don't judge.
Scrambled egg, flat cap mushrooms. Just keep them whole and put them in the pan. Lots of olive oil.
Alright, that seems a bit excessive,
but alright. A little bit of pepper. Mm-hmm. Vine tomatoes. Best way of
tomatoes.
Roasting these is actually keep them on the vine. In the pan.
That's with a cute little garnish. Alright, but why?
Just let those mushrooms sit there in the pan on a low heat and
seems a little
themselves.
Extra.
Nothing worse than going into
Alright, pause. Okay, maybe I will judge a little bit. That bread?
Restaurant, having scrambled egg on toast
and
having
soggy
toast. This here.
That's a rock. That's. There's kryptonite in there, right? Like, where did you get this? Ugh, Gordon, alright, okay. I mean, master chef after all, so... I really can't judge what he's doing, so... Please.
Is a sourdough bread. And the reason why we're going to use it for scrambled egg is because it's strong, robust,
did he
and
just...
it's got a lovely flavour to it.
Did he have that in a drawer?
You cut it because you don't want this sort of little thin... tight, sort of fisted slice of bread. Nice and thick, chunky bread.
So he's probably gonna put that
into
in his
toaster.
Oh, he's putting that in his toaster, okay.
We always ask them to make scrambled egg. And if they can make the perfect scrambled egg, you know they know how to cook properly. Mm. Start off with 3 eggs. Okay. Now, don't season it. Because if you put the salt in now, what actually happens, it breaks down the eggs.
All right, why is he putting it in the pot?
And turning them into something sort of very watery. So, eggs in the pan. Nice knob of butter. And it's really important to put the butter in right at the very beginning because what that does
starts
giving
that.
A really nice velvety finish to scrambled egg.
Okay.
And then a simple spatula. Onto the heat. Never whisk the egg. Whisk it in the pan. Because when you start sort of whisking beforehand, you're breaking it all down. You've got to break it down in the pan. But the secret behind the scrambled egg is to start it on a nice sort of generous
what
heat.
Do your
take
arteries
heat,
look like?
Go back to the heat. Take it off the heat. And treat it like a risotto. You can't stop stirring. It's live. You've got to really work at it. Now,
I mean,
it's starting to come together.
Okay,
it's starting
that's
to go
cool,
a little bit
I guess.
Thick. I'll come back off the heat and just let it work. And just do this 3 or 4 times. Back onto the heat. Now, if I had to season this now, it'd still turn it into something quite watery. And I want a really nice sort of creamy scrambled egg. Something quite fluffy. Shh, is that my toast?
Oh, there we go. Alright, does he seem weirder than we remember? Because I remember the scary, yelly guy. But, I don't know, he seems like a cool dude. He's, yeah, I don't know, there's something off here. I mean, he's moving real fast, it's like early in the morning. I'm not saying he's on cocaine, but I'm not saying it. I'm just kidding, but like... this dude, I feel like, could, like, rip my asshole out with his, like, spatula or something. Not in a sexual way. I mean, like, he would fucking kill me way. Anyway!
Burning. Off the heat. Oh, damn, I'm gonna set the fire alarms off.
What? Hold up. Gordon Ramsay burned his toast! I feel so much better about myself now. Oh. Who's gonna... no one's yawning at him. Oh my god. I feel like if I burned toast, my anus would look heinous. You get what I'm saying? On pause.
Wake up the missus. Okay, here we go. Put that back in. So.
And his wife is sleeping upstairs while this is filming.
Right.
That does not look good.
Then, as you can see now, look, it's almost starting to sort of, you know, continue cooking. Doesn't need to go back on the stove.
I can see how, like, someone might like it.
Because the heat is in there.
Alright, yeah, I know how that works.
So, look,
thank you.
If I had to leave that there now, it would overcook. But it's not going to overcook because I'm going to put half a tablespoon of creme fraiche.
Alright, you lost me. You lost me with
the... Now, it just makes it a little bit...
You lost me with the Randy Marsh special ingredient. No. I am not making this.
Cooler. Brings down the temperature of the eggs. Now,
that
I'm
looks...
season it. A little bit of salt. And then it's a
I'm sure it tastes amazing, but...
Just to finish that...
Just season your spatula?
A little touch of chives in there. And what
fucking
that does,
legend?
It just lifts the whole flavor of the scrambled egg and just makes it a little bit more sexy.
A little more sexy,
you know,
yeah.
Sometimes
what?
You want to be a little more extravagant. You can put some smoked salmon in there.
Smoked salmon?
No. And just fold those chives in.
Bruh.
There we are. The perfect scrambled egg. Okay, to serve it, we're ready to go. On.
Okay, I mean.
The vine tomatoes. That's why we leave them on the vine, you see, because you just pick them out of the pan like that.
Okay.
Sit them on there.
I feel like this is like a lot of.
I found a little bit of olive oil in there.
What? Bro, what do you think I have in my kitchen?
Over.
That just looks like.
And there you go, a perfect scrambled egg. I mean, the most
don't
amazing
mind the guy
way of waking up
grass. He's just doing his job,
morning.
But like,
so if you want to be a good boy, run upstairs now and give it to her in bed. The breakfast.
Bruh. Alright. That seemed unnecessarily, like, extra. So, yeah, I don't know, maybe I'll watch another one of his videos in the future, but someone sent me another video. It seems like pretty simple instructions. So let's just put this on and see where this goes.
Hey guys, it's Greg's Kitchen Time once again. And today I thought I'd show you how I like to cook my bacon and eggs. Now I cook this 3 to 4 times a week.
It's like Willem Dafoe, fuck Stifler.
So let me show you the way that I cook it, so you can love it too. Come on, let's start.
Alright. The next episode
okay,
of
so
Noir.
For this, I've got my bacon, eggs, and of course, I cook tomato because it's really good for your prostate. And I want my pecker to work for a long time.
What?
And of course, we're also going to need some toast. Now, I'm going to start the toast cooking because it doesn't matter if the toast is cold or not. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do
really
is
scary
I'm just
looking.
Cut my bacon.
Why is everything about you terrifying?
Because then it might fit in the pan easier. Now,
so
I like
why?
To use a nice fatty bacon.
Is there like something about tomato I don't know about?
To melt and flavor right. Everything else
let's skip
in
ahead.
The pan. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is... Well, the first thing
wait, let's see what he does here. Hang on.
Get my tomato on, because the tomatoes
tomato
take
on.
The longest to cook. So I'm going to put some salt on there, and I'm also going to put some raw sugar. Now, this sugar just flavors the tomato unbelievably. And it also does another thing as well, which I'll mention.
This is unnerving. I don't know why, but
so put a heap of it on. Look, I'll just put a little bit more. Why
a little
not?
Bit more.
Now this is a non-stick pan, so I'm not going to need any oil. But the first thing I'm going to do is get these tomatoes on because they take the longest to cook. So I'll put those on first. Now, as you can see already, the salt, sugar, and the juice from the tomato is all combining to get those flavors.
This is very, very uncomfortable. So let's skip ahead to... Let's go to 227. And play.
We're really looking for in a great piece of bacon. So I'll just flip that over as well. That rind is starting to cook up nicely. I use my hands. Because I can.
No, you should not.
You know, I think I just took some skin off because that bacon was so hot. Oh, boy.
And you did it again,
so,
you
yeah,
fucking idiot. Switch
that bacon around in where the sugar was.
Don't ever let this man cook for you.
And that'll add some flavor. Now,
boy,
once
I'll reduce
that,
some flesh
I'm
off my bone.
Tomatoes back over.
Tomato. Crikey.
Because I really want the other side cooked well. Okay, well, those tomatoes, as you can see there,
right.
Are nice
I mean,
and
I might try
dark
that.
And caramelized
shits
on the top.
And giggles,
so
but I'm not
going to
add the sugar.
Now. The reason being is because they take quite a while to cool down, and you don't want to be burning your mouth on them. So I'll take those off. This bacon is looks like it's almost done, actually. So I'm just going to pile it up in the corner.
Corner.
And take that corner sort of off the hot plate, so it just slows its cooking process down.
Am I going to be shocked or disappointed at the amount of bodies in his basement? Let's keep watching and find out.
And now it's time to add the egg in where most of the bacon fat was. Boy, that was a big egg, and it has leaked everywhere. So now all I have to do is cook that egg to my desired way of eating my eggs, which is over easy, and breakfast will be done. Right, well, I'm just going to take that bacon off and plate it up, because that's looking crispy yet succulent.
Succulent.
I'll get some of this fat and run it down into where the egg is too.
Yeah, I don't give a fuck about my arteries.
I really want that bacon fat.
I want to die at a heart. I want to have a heart attack at the age of 12. Yeah, flip,
give it a
fry
quick
it too. Yeah, definitely, definitely. That'll...
And bang!
I'm not
straight
doing
on that piece of toast.
Onto the butter.
Oh, just cooked before, and that's it. Your bacon and egg breakfast just done in minutes. How beautiful and healthy looking is that?
It's not healthy looking at all.
Well, I really hope
you enjoy neither are you.
And eggs, I know how much I love them all. I love it more than bacon.
What?
So enjoy that. Remember to like my Facebook page.
Not doing that.
Subscribe for more.
No.
And I'll see you next time right
here.
You
most certainly will not. I hope I will be very comfortable if I never see your face again. Alright, so yeah, I came away from that being more terrified and confused than having learned anything. I'm definitely not doing anything this fucking maniac did, and I don't have any creme fraiche, so I'm not gonna do the fucking Gordon Ramsay thing. Alright, I'll just stick with how I've been doing it, because I'm sure these guys know what they're doing. I'm just gonna let them be them. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you all in the next episode of... I don't care anymore. Bye.